History of Ayas of year 360 AD to 2020. The Hagia Sophia, Hagia Sophia in Turkey, was originally built as a basilica for the Greek Orthodox Christian Church. Construction of the first Hagia Sophia in 360 AD. At the time of the first church's construction, Istanbul was known as Constantinople, taking its name from Constantius' father, Constantine I, the first ruler of the Byzantine Empire. The first Hagia Sophia featured a wooden roof. The structure was burned to the ground in 404 AD. During the riots that occurred in Constantinople as a result of political conflicts within the family of then Emperor Arcadius, who had a tumultuous reign from 395 to 480 AD, Arcadius' successor, Emperor Theodosius II, rebuilt the Hagia Sophia, and the new structure was completed in 415. The second Hagia Sophia contained five naves and a monumental entrance and was also covered by a wooden roof. However, a little more than one century later, this would again prove to be a fatal flaw for this important basilica of the Greek Orthodox faith. As the structure was burnt for a second time during the so-called Nika revolts against Emperor Justinian I, who ruled from 527 to 565, unable to repair the damage caused by the fire, Justinian ordered the demolition of the Hagia Sophia in 532. He commissioned renowned architects Isidoros of Milet and Anthemios Tralles to build a new basilica. The third Hagia Sophia was completed in 537, and it remains standing today. The first religious services in the new Hagia Sophia were held on December 27, 537. At the time, Emperor Justinian is reported to have said, "My Lord, thank you for giving me the chance to create such a worshipping place." From its opening, the third and final Hagia Sophia was indeed a remarkable structure. It combined the traditional design elements of an Orthodox basilica with a large domed roof and a semi-domed altar with toned earthenings. The dome's supporting arches were covered with mosaics of six-winged angels called hexapterygon. The marble used for the floor and ceiling was produced in Anatolia, present-day eastern Turkey and Syria, while other bricks used in the walls and parts of the floor came from as far away as North Africa. The interior of Hagia Sophia is lined with enormous marble slabs that are said to have been designed to imitate moving water. In an effort to create a grand basilica that represented all of the Byzantine Empire, Emperor Justinian decreed that all provinces under his rule send architectural pieces for use in its construction. The Hagia Sophia's 104 columns were imported from the Temple of Artemis in Ephesus as well as from Egypt. The building measures some 269 feet in length and 240 feet in width. At its highest point, the domed roof stretches some 180 feet into the air. When the first dome suffered a partial collapse in 557, its replacement was designed by Isidore the Younger, the nephew of Isidoros, one of the original architects, with structural ribs and a more pronounced arc. And this version of the structure remains in place today. This central dome rests on a ring of windows and is supported by two semi-domes and two arched openings to create a large nave, the walls of which were originally lined with intricate Byzantine mosaics made from gold, silver, glass, terracotta and colorful stones, and portraying well-known scenes and figures from the Christian Gospels. These ceremonies took place in the nave, where there is an omphalian table of the earth. A large circular marble section of colorful stones in an intertwining circular design in the floor. As the Greek Orthodox was the official religion of the Byzantines, Sophia was considered the main church of faith, and it became the place where the new emperor was wearing the crown. The Hagia Sophia served this pivotal role in Byzantine culture and politics for much of its first 900 years of existence. During the Crusades, the city of Constantinople, and by extension the Hagia Sophia, was under Roman control for a brief period in the 13th century. The Hagia Sophia was severely damaged during this period but was repaired when the Byzantines once again took control of the surrounding city. The next significant period of change for the Hagia Sophia began less than 200 years later when the Ottomans, led by Emperor Fatih Sultan Mehmed, known as Mehmed the Conqueror, captured Constantinople in 1453. The Ottomans renamed the city Istanbul, as Islam was the central religion of the Ottomans. The Hagia Sophia was renovated into a mosque. As part of the conversion, the Ottomans covered many of the original Orthodox themed mosaics with Islamic calligraphy designed by Gaziskar Mustafaezi. The panels or medallions, which were hung on the columns in the nave, featured the names of Allah, the Prophet Muhammad, the first four caliphs, and the Prophet's two grandsons. The mosaic on the main dome, believed to be an image of Christ, was covered by gold calligraphy. A mihrab or nave was installed in the wall, as is tradition in mosques, to indicate the direction toward Makkah, one of the holy cities of Islam. Ottoman Emperor Qanun Sultan Suleiman, 1520-1566, installed two bronze lamps on each side of the mihrab. And Sultan Murad III, 1574-1595, added two marble cubes from the Turkish city of Bergama, which date back to 4 BC. Four minarets were also added to the original building during this period, partly for religious purposes, for the muezzin call to prayer, and partly to fortify the structure following earthquakes that struck the city around this time. Under the rule of Sultan Abdul Majid I, between 1847 and 1849, the Hagia Sophia underwent an extensive renovation led by Swiss architects, the Fossati brothers. At this time, the Hunkum Avili, a separate compartment for emperors to use for prayer, was removed and replaced with another near the mihrab. The Hagia Sophia's role in politics and religion remains a contentious one even today, some 100 years after the fall of the Ottoman Empire. Since 1935, 9 years after the Republic of Turkey was established by Atatürk, the legendary structure has been operated as a museum by the national government, and it reportedly attracts more than 3 million visitors annually. However, since 2013, some Islamic religious leaders in the country have sought to have the Hagia Sophia once again opened as a mosque. And the debate isn't just a religious one. For much of the 21st century, Turkey's society has witnessed a rise in nationalistic fervor, with the growing recognition of the Ottoman era as being a fundamental part of the country's history, as the capture of Istanbul and the Hagia Sophia from the Orthodox Greeks by the Muslim Ottomans is considered a high water mark of that period. There are some who are advocating for the building's use as a mosque as a symbol of this history. Today, the current Hagia Sophia is 1,478 years old and has survived hundreds of earthquakes throughout history. Its age, size, magnificence, architecture and mystical atmosphere make it truly a unique place in the world. Istanbul President Recep Tayyip Erdoğan sealed his long-stated desire to restore the historic Hagia Sophia as a working mosque on Friday, the 24th of July 2020, opening the magnificent Byzantine structure built in the 6th century as the world's largest cathedral to thousands of Muslim worshippers for the first time in nearly nine decades.